Good afternoon to all the viewers of Pilot Stories. I'm Captain Denis, and I'm really happy to see all of you here on board our 737, which is approaching the city of Perm. And you are right. In the right seat of this glorious aircraft is a lady. Her name is Maria, and she has already appeared here on my channel. The link to the video in which she gracefully lands the same Boeing 737 at Vnukovo Airport, you can now see in the upper right corner of the screen, and it can also be found in the description of this video. At the beginning of my career on the 737, I often flew to here. One of my most memorable flights was to Perm. It was my first and, I hope, the last forced landing. Late in the evening, we flew from Moscow to Perm. I was a young 27-year-old captain, and my co-pilot, Dmitry, was 5 years older. During climb, Yulia, the senior flight attendant, asked permission to enter the flight deck. She was greatly concerned about the fact that something was hitting the right side of the airplane from the outside. She said that one of the windows was already covered with cracks. This information was really surprising for me and Dmitry. Dmitry went to the cabin, then came back and said, "Yes. It's hitting really hard." But he couldn't determine the reason. We decided not to continue the flight, and returned to the departure airport, where we discovered the reason of this situation. Before the flight, the technicians were doing a regular check of the aircraft, which required to open overwing exits. On the 737-500, every overwing exit is equipped with an escape strap with a metal hook on its end. In case of evacuation, it can be fixed in the special ring on the upper side of the wing. When removed, this strap is folded into a bag that should be closed with Velcro, but at this exit, the Velcro was in a bad condition. One of the technicians simply rolled up the strap, put it on top of the hatch, and closed it. But a part of the strap with the hook remained outside. It was dark, the strap was grey, the exit contour was also coloured grey. Nobody, including me, noticed this problem during the pre-flight inspection. This was a very good experience for me, a young captain. So, imagine that it is the end of April, late in the evening. Having taken off a couple of hours ago from Pulkovo Airport of St. Petersburg, we are approaching Perm. Starting reducing the airspeed. I cancelled the no ice light. This light means that no ice is detected anymore. I set the new commanded altitude of 2,700 feet on the mode control panel, MCP, and switched the autopilot to vertical speed mode of descent, and also reduced the airspeed to 220 knots. We need to set the flaps to 1. The speed is slightly high, so I'm using the speed brake to slow down. Now the vertical speed has reduced to 1000 feet per minute. This is a good shallow descent, the airspeed will be decreasing, so, after getting sure it was reducing, I retracted the speed brake, and commanded the autopilot to fly with flaps 1 speed. The speed is smoothly going down. We are flying the base turn now. Approaching the transition level. Here we change the altimeter's reference to the airport atmospheric pressure. Reading the approach checklist, which consists of only one item, to cross-check the altimeters. Upon my command, Maria extends the flaps to 5. I'm reducing the speed to flaps 5 speed. Speaking more correctly, I've just told the autopilot what speed I wanted to reach in the near future. The speed is still slightly high, but because of the increased drag, it will go down to the commanded value. Turning final. I mean, turning towards the landing runway, and getting on the final landing track. I'm setting the runway heading on the MCP. Actually, in the present autopilot mode, this does nothing. But it can be helpful in case of a missed approach. Besides this, it is good to see the runway heading bug on the displays when flying manually. Arming the approach mode to let the automation capture the localizer and glide slope beams of the ILS, instrumental landing system. On the CDU, Control display unit of the flight management computer. I'm selecting the approach reference page to have the actual landing weight and reference approach speed in sight. The autopilot and the auto throttle are disengaged. The flight continues in the manual mode from now. The throttles are at idle thrust. I'm smoothly reducing the speed down to the flaps 5 speed. By using the stabilizer trim, I remove the residual forces on the yoke. These forces are simulated by the elevator feels system. If the airplane wouldn't be controlled by boosters, for example, would it be Antonov 2, the aerodynamic pressure would create the backward forces on the flight controls, which will increase with the speed. Because here we do have boosters, and there is no feedback on the yoke, there is a special system installed, which imitates these atmospheric inputs. Now you can see the runway ahead. We are approaching the glide slope. This is a final descent trajectory. The most interesting part is about to begin, the one why we are here. Glide slope capture happened at the same time with altitude acquire, and now we continue descent along the glide slope. At 2,500 feet over the terrain, the radio altimeter starts working. Actually, it's working throughout the flight, but the indication comes on at this height. The distance to the runway is about 7 nautical miles. Soon I will give a command to get the gear down, and for further flaps extension. Maria sets the lever to down. Ha! It looks like I was a little bit on a hurry with extending the gear. It could have been done later. But nothing bad anyway. I gave a command to set the flaps 15. And to set the airspeed bug to the flaps 15 speed. I'm giving the command for flaps 30. This is our landing flaps position for today. Giving the command to set the approach speed. Actually, I'm controlling the speed manually, but the bug assists me in doing this. Doing the landing checklist. The checklist is done, the landing clearance has been already received, and the only thing remained is to bring the airplane to the runway, and return it from the sky. Lower the height is, the air becomes more bumpy. It attempts to get the airplane off the path, this needs to be counteracted, so I need to work with the yoke a little bit. One thousand feet, the approach is stabilized. Continue the approach. A special system informed us that we were approaching runway 21.
Approaching
100 feet to the decision altitude. The runway is clearly in sight, the approach is stabilized, continue.
100.
Slightly pulling the yoke, smoothly retarding the throttles. Another gentle pulling, and landing. Or as usual, nothing new. the spoilers raised at the wing. I'm smoothly flying the nose wheel to the runway, deploying the engine reversers, rolling out and braking. One more successful landing has just happened. While we were decelerating, the fuel in the center tank went forward, exposing the sensors, and the low pressure lights came on. This is a normal situation. According to the controller's instruction, I'm making a 180 turn on the runway in order to roll back and vacate the runway to the left to the apron. Ha! Everyone turns here. Ahead, you can see the lights of the aircraft on final. The distance is about 7 nautical miles, they are far away from us, nevertheless, we need to try to vacate the runway in order not to create troubles to them. Vacating the runway, doing necessary procedures. We are met by a follow me car. Apparently, the airport is worried that we can get lost here. Ha, thanks for your concern. The stand is close, so, Maria turns on the APU, auxiliary power unit. It will provide the electrical power to the airplane at the parking. In order not to blind the marshaler, we switch off the taxi lights before turning to the stand. Following the marshaler instructions, I'm parking the airplane, and stop it at the commanded point. Getting closer. Closer? Okay, we are here. Setting on the parking brake, and informing the marshaler about it by giving a special gesture. Maria switches on the APU generators. I shut down the engines, Maria switches off the fasten belt signs. Well, one more flight is about to get over. Just need to do some procedures, read the checklist, say goodbye to the passengers, and then we'll go to the hotel to fresh up before continuing our journey. Thank you very much for your attention. I wish you all the best. See you. Fly safe.